been in so much trouble.
I am so sorry. That's really bad. What are you gonna do about it?
I'm gonna tell my parents, ask them to forgive me, and be careful next time.
I'm so sorry, Bob. That sounds like a good plan, though. A very good plan. Boys and girls, can you think of a time when something that you loved or that was important broke? How did you feel about it? And were you able to put it all back together again? Hopefully so. You know, we have all had something that broke, that we wish we could fix and make perfect again. When God's people were taken into exile, the Babylonians completely destroyed their temple. Yikes. Today we're going to hear how God's people rebuilt the temple 70 years later. Stay tuned. So Bob, what is something hard that you have had to do in life and it was so hard that you just wanted to give up?
Well, telling my dad about the broken phone was really hard.
I bet it was.
Now I have to mow the lawn for a whole month to pay for it. A whole month, Miss Sandy! That's forever! I get so tired, I just want to quit.
Yeah, you build up those arm muscles with that, Mr. Bob.
Yeah.
But don't give up. Sometimes we have to do really hard things that we don't think we can even finish. Well, today we're going to hear how God's people wanted to give up when they were rebuilding the temple.
Ooh, I wonder why.
Right. We will find out here at
GranadaKids.
Good morning, GranadaKids. I'm Miss Michelle. Today we will hear about two prophets, Haggai and Zechariah. God's people must have been so thankful for them, because they were sent to encourage them. Our big picture question and answer tell us about a prophet who's even greater than these men, who were already awesome, by the way. His name is Jesus. I know you've heard a lot about him, but let's hear a question together. The question is, how is Jesus the perfect prophet? The answer is, Jesus perfectly reveals God the Father and fulfills what the prophets spoke. Because Jesus is God the Son, his words, thoughts, and actions provided a perfect example of what God is like. Many prophecies in the Old Testament have already come true through Jesus, and all of them will come true in the future. Let's see this morning what some prophet told God's people. Bye, guys. Have a great day. God bless.
GranadaKids, it is so good to be at church with you this morning and to have a place to worship God together. Now, in this activity, we're going to build a temple together. What? How is that even possible? We don't have any lumber. We don't have any nails. I'm not quite sure where the tools are. But you're not going to be needing any of that. Younger children will use blocks, but it won't be so easy for you older kiddos. You will be using playing cards, dun dun dun. That may not produce the most secure structure, so let's see how you do. Form two groups of kids. Each group will get a deck of cards, and each group must pick one leader to cheer on the group and encourage them as they build. You see, that is a very important job. After several minutes, let's compare your amazing structures. Make them so beautiful, and let's get started building, boys and girls. Great job building! How helpful or encouraging was your leader? When God's people were rebuilding the temple in Jerusalem, God sent two prophets, Haggai and Zechariah, to encourage the people. Today, we will learn more about how and why God's people rebuilt the temple. Stay tuned.
After living in Babylon for 70 years, God's people were home. A group had returned to Jerusalem to rebuild God's temple. He had started the work, but their neighbors didn't want them to rebuild the temple, so they stopped building. The people made excuses. Maybe it isn't the right time to rebuild the temple, they said. They thought that because the task was difficult, maybe God didn't want them to do it. God sent the prophets Haggai and Zechariah to encourage the people. So the leaders, Zerubbabel and Joshua, started working on the temple again. At this time, Darius, the king of Persia, ruled over the land of Judah. The king was in charge of so much land, he put governors in charge of some of the land. A governor named Tattenai noticed God's people had started to rebuild the temple again. Tattenai talked to Zerubbabel and the others working on the temple. "Do you have permission to rebuild this temple?" Tattenai asked. The workers said, "We do." Tattenai sent a worker to King Darius. This is what Tattenai's letter to King Darius said. "To Darius the king, this letter is to tell you that the people of Judah are building the temple of the great God. They said King Cyrus gave them permission to rebuild the temple. Please search the royal records to see if this is true." King Darius's officials searched the royal record for Cyrus's order. They found it, a scroll with a record from King Cyrus. This is what was written on the scroll. "Let God's temple be rebuilt. It will be a place to offer sacrifices. Let its foundation be rebuilt." King Cyrus had also ordered for the cost of building the temple to be paid for out of the royal treasury. So King Darius sent a letter back to Tattenai. He gave this order: "Stay away from the workers in Jerusalem. Don't bother them or try to stop them. Give them whatever they need." Tattenai and the other officials obeyed King Darius' order. The Jewish leader kept building, and they finally finished the temple of God. The people celebrated and made offerings to God. They chose priests and assistants to serve in the temple. Then God's people celebrated the Passover. God's people were so happy. Now, the temple of God was finally complete. God's people rebuilt the temple so they would have a place to worship God. Years later, God sent his son, Jesus, to be with his people. Now God dwells not in the temple, but directly with his people. Jesus provided something better than the temple. He gives us himself.
So hard. Life can be so hard, whether it be mowing a lawn like Bob experienced or building a temple. Just because God's people were home doesn't mean that it was easy. Their national wealth was gone. Rebuilding the temple and the city of Jerusalem was really hard. Their crops failed. Their neighbors gave them a hard time. It was not a pretty picture. They were discouraged. They were disappointed. And they gave up. The temple of the Lord sat unfinished for 16 years, and the people made excuses. They said, "Well, maybe it's not time to rebuild the temple," they reasoned, because if that was what God wanted, wouldn't he make it easier for them? There are two things you can take away from this lesson. I mean, there's plenty, but I'll focus on two. Just because something is hard does not mean that it is not God's will for you. Press on. Don't give up. And also, number two, listen to God's word. He will encourage you. The prophet Haggai, which you can read about in the book by his name, little book in the Old Testament, Haggai brought words from the Lord telling his people to finish the work they started. And he encouraged them that God promised to fill the temple with his glory. And God gave this promise: "I will provide peace in this place." How awesome is that? But they lost sight of that. So keep looking to Jesus, boys and girls, because he will provide everything we need as we follow him.
morning, Granada Kids. I'm Miss Kathy. Let's read our key passage from the book of Jeremiah. I know the plans I have for you. This is the Lord's declaration. Plans for your well-being, not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope. Jeremiah 29:11. Do you think it would have been encouraging for God's people to remember the truth of this verse? God had a plan for them, plans for hope and a future. Nothing was going to stop God's plan to rebuild his temple. He knew the trials they would face in rebuilding the temple. God didn't promise to make the process easy for them, but he did promise to be with them along the way. A similar promise is true for us today. God has given us hope and a future through Jesus's perfect obedience, sacrificial death, and miraculous resurrection because of our Savior. We have hope for eternity with God. As you sing the key passage song, remember that this same God calls you to trust him today.
I know the plans I have for you. This is the Lord's declaration. Plans for your well-being, not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope. To give you a future and a hope. I know the plans I have for you. This is the Lord's declaration.
Phoebe, please bow your head and pray with me. Dear God, we praise you because of your faithful love. You work all things together for our good and for your glory. Help us to see your glory in our broken world. Help us to believe that whatever the circumstances, you are good. You give us strength when we are weak. You lift us up when we feel like giving up. Thank you for being with us always, especially through difficult times. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
I am so grateful that God did not create us and then leave us alone. He has always desired to be with us and have relationship with us. That is why God's people built a temple and also rebuilt the temple. Now, each of you will receive a paper and a marker, and I'm going to want you to turn your page sideways and draw a line down the middle of the page like so. Now, on the left side of your page, you're going to label it Temple Then, and on the right side of the page, you're going to label it Temple Now. look at the Bible story picture on the screen and draw the temple on the left side of the page. And when you're done with that, then draw a self-portrait on the right side of the page. What? That's right, a self-portrait. A self-portrait is a picture of yourself. So draw your face. Pause the video and draw those temples. Ta-da! Your pictures represent the temple then and now. God's people rebuilt the temple to glorify God. The temple gave them a place to worship God. Years later, God sent his son, Jesus, to be with his people. Now God dwells not in a temple building, but directly within his people. Jesus provided something better than the temple. He gives us himself. That is amazing, boys and girls. May each of our lives glorify him as he lives in us. Amen.
Hey, boys and girls. So good having you with us today. Hope you learned a lot. Today's lesson, we learned that God's people rebuilt the temple to glorify him. They almost quit, but God sent prophets like Haggai to encourage them to keep on going. And thankfully, now that Jesus has come, the temple isn't necessary. For Jesus teaches that our body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit abides in us. And because of that, we can meet with God wherever we are, simply through prayer. And boys and girls, I hope you spend time with Jesus through prayer. Have a blessed week, boys and girls. Bye.